Greetings, Earthlings. Welcome to Planet Alien here on YouTube. As you can tell, I'm, like, not put together, so, yeah. Let's move on, because I want to make this. It's about Archie Andrews from Riverdale, if you do not know who I'm talking about. I'm sure once you had Archie, you're probably like, oh, the comic books. And I'm like, yeah. No, okay, so I am the first one to say, like, I know season two Archie for a while there was just so frustrating, and I just wanted to, like, punch him in the face sometimes, to be honest, or just yell at him and be like, what the hell is up with you? Wake up! Wake up! It's like when you're trying to wake up someone from a dream that they're or a nightmare that they're having about Freddy Krueger, and you can't, and it's too late, and they're dead. No. That's just the way to explain that, I guess. But, I realized that a lot of people kind of started to dislike Archie and see him as a bad friend, and I understand that. Like, I've loved Archie since season one, episode one. I just have. I mean, it has nothing to do with KJ, per se, or the comics. It just, I love Archie. I just loved him instantly. I really did. I mean, of course, he made dumb mistakes like Miss Grundy, and of course, he just said stupid shit and treated Jughead like shit for a period, and then made up with him, of course. You know, and he's done and made mistakes, which they all have. But especially season one, he made a lot of dumb mistakes. But all in all, I loved Archie, you know, I still did, because he's a teenager, you're gonna make mistakes, you know, they're all flawed in their own way. Then season two, I mean, with the Black Hood and Hiram, his mind got warped totally, like, completely and utterly warped, and I think that's what we have to remember. I understand how frustrating Archie was in season two, like, until just now, like, the end of season two, he finally woke up and actually is like, fuck you, Hiram, I'm taking you down. But before that, it was all Hiram this, Hiram that, Hiram this, Hiram that. You know, he was always around Hiram, always supporting Hiram, you know? I mean, for God's sake, he unchained his best friend. I mean, that was a huge moment. I mean, that was the beginning of a war, basically, which is what Hiram wanted. But I know that, with that being said, Archie did a lot of shit that I'm really pissed about in season two. But I understood why, because I know the Black Hood warped his mind, but I guess I didn't really consider that Hiram warped his mind. I know that Hiram was kind of, like, using him, I knew that, but I didn't really think about it as, it's not that the Black Hood warped Archie's mind, it's also that Hiram did. Hiram saw the state he was in because of the Black Hood, and he took advantage of that, and therefore warped Archie's mind even more by thinking, because if the Black Hood never would have happened, I guarantee Archie never would have been on board for these prison plans, you know. Yeah, of course, he probably still would have proved himself to Hiram because Veronica is his girlfriend, he loves her. But I don't think he would have went down the road he did and chose the choices he chose, you know. So I think Hiram played a big part in changing Archie in season two. It wasn't just the Black Hood that kind of changed him. It was also Hiram playing on that and making the change in Archie more and more noticeable and more bigger and honestly worse for his character. Because, you know, I mean, even though when he was doing this stupid shit for Hiram, he still had those moments where he's like, don't get in the way of me and my dad's relationship, like, you can't, that's not cool, you know. He still, of course, had that loyalty to his dad. Wish he would have had it to Jughead. Like, that's another thing, people are like, I don't really see him as a good friend, which is understandable, because he did do shitty things to Jughead in season two, like, a lot of shitty things, he really did. And I mean, he did shitty things all around in season two, but you gotta understand, friendship, it's not always perfect. Of course, you're going to do, like I said, his mind was warped. He wasn't in his right set of mind. And I think Jughead knows that, which is why Jughead didn't hold a grudge for what Archie did. Because it's not that he blamed Archie. You know, he knows who Archie is truly. It's just, in season two, his mind was completely warped that it wasn't the Archie we all knew and loved. And a lot of people really resent him or kind of stopped liking him because of that. And even though he redeemed himself in the end, people still are like, well, he still did all this bad shit, and he was such a bad friend to Jughead and Betty and all this stuff. And it's like, I understand that, and I was totally against Archie, like, doing that shit to Jughead. Like, I'm not for it. Like, that's your best friend. Like, I don't understand how you can keep doing this to him. But in the end, it's like, that's friendship in a way. Like, well, you know what? Actually, now that I'm talking about it, it's like Archie. I am like, okay. Yeah, Archie isn't the best friend to Jughead. He isn't. I mean, he has. I mean, he is a good friend to him, but at the same time, he's not. I mean, season one, you know, he was really pissy about Miss Grundy, but they made up, so that wasn't a big deal. Season two, again, he wasn't that good a friend, but again, his mind was warped. I mean, I'm not saying that he was, like, being controlled. I'm just saying, you gotta think that the impact that the Black Hood had on Archie, watching his dad be shot, having a gun put to his head, not being able to do anything. How would you react? How would that affect you? And then on top of that, you have this powerful guy who has all these plans for making Riverdale safer. And of course, Archie wants to protect his dad. So of course, he's on board with Hiram. And, sorry. So of course, like, you gotta just think about that and how, why Archie was the way he was in season two. And you gotta understand, every character is gonna go through a phase where you're just like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, get your head on straight. What are you doing? Like, Veronica, season two wasn't her best season either, until towards the end when she finally stood up to her dad. But before that, she had her moments lying to her friends, you know, and manipulating people. You know, she had those moments, and I disliked her for it. But she changed, you know, she realized. She opened her eyes and saw the truth, and she realized that she doesn't want to be this person that she was before in New York with her dad. She wants to be the person she's become in Riverdale, and that person's good. And I'm glad that she opened her eyes to that and taking these steps towards kind of taking down her dad is a big thing, and it's going to get even bigger now that he's arrested, or he's had Archie framed for murder. But I'm just saying, like, you gotta give Archie a break. I'm not saying you have to like him. If you don't like him, that's fine. I'm just saying, understand why he did a lot of things in season two. Kind of understand that. And understand that in the end, they still were all best friends. They still all came together. And in the end, it was them against Hiram. Yes, Archie was on Hiram's side for the longest time, but it's not all his fault. I mean, when you're in that state of mind, you just want to protect those you love no matter what. And the prison sounded like a great idea. He didn't think much into, oh, all this stuff is going to happen. And you got to think, Archie basically witnessed a murder with that Cassidy kid in the woods and didn't do anything about it or say anything. And that's not the Archie we know and love. So you got to think, that's a different Archie. What kind of state of mind is he in that that's the person he's become? But towards the end of season two, you start to see him kind of shift back to his old self. Of course, none of the characters are going to get back to season one selves, but he's starting to gain control of his life again and kind of really realize what's going on and who's the bad guy and who's the good guy, you know? So I think that we got to give Archie another chance, because I think possibly every season our characters are going to go through something and we're going to hate them for a while or dislike them for a while, and then we're going to go back to loving them. But no matter if we dislike them or not, we're still, of course, loving them. We're just disliking the choices they make. And I just wanted to kind of explain, like, Archie Andrews' situation and, like, why you should give him another chance and not really, like, I'm not saying don't hate him. I'm just saying, you know, give him another chance. You know, he really had, he had a bad go in season two. Veronica did too for a while there. But they came back better and stronger than ever in the end. And I mean, it's a new journey. Now he's taking down Hiram instead of working with Hiram. Which, and he even opened his eyes and admitted that Hiram took advantage of him, which he did so clearly. I mean, come on. Like, that's such a traumatic situation to be in. Especially your dad could have died. I mean, I couldn't even imagine. But yeah, so Archie, I love Archie. I always will. Jughead, of course, is like my love of Riverdale. Of course, I love him the most because I relate to him the most. Where Betty, I relate to her a little more on the mental illness issues. I relate to that more. So, you know, like, I relate to characters in different ways. But Jughead's like kind of like my, I don't know what it would be called. Jughead's kind of like my, I don't even know. He's my spirit animal, I guess you could say. Like, I don't know. He's just like, he's me in a nutshell, basically. But, you know, with differences. But Archie, I still love and always will love. I mean, he's Archie Andrews. You know, I love him. He is a good guy deep down. It's just he makes mistakes, and he's a kid. You gotta realize that. 16 years old, they're gonna make stupid ass fucking mistakes, like hooking up with their teacher. And it's not always gonna be so black and white, you know? It's going to be a lot different. And over time, you know, our characters are going to change. They're going to do things. They're going to make choices that we might not like or we may like. But at the end of the day, I think we still love these characters because they're flawed and it makes it relatable. Because we don't want a character who's perfect. We want a character who's flawed, who's human, you know? And so, like, just consider what Archie was going through and what his state of mind was in season two before you decide that you just hate him or don't like him anymore because of what happened in season two. And if you don't think he is a good friend, you're probably in the right, honestly. I mean, he hasn't been a good friend to Jughead, I'm gonna be honest. He hasn't. It towards the end, of course, he was, but before that he wasn't. And I think that kind of does suck, but I also want to look at it like his state of mind and how he was feeling, you know, like I kind of want to justify it by what he was going through and how his mind was so warped. But I do agree that he was a bad friend and that I hope he's a better friend to Jughead and he stops going back and forth with being a bad friend and a good friend to Jughead and just actually being a good friend. I will say that. But I just want to kind of explain Archie Andrews and kind of explain why I still love him despite what he did in season two. Because even though he redeemed himself in the end, it doesn't matter. You still did all that shit in season two that really pissed me off. And of course, I'm going to be pissed. But I'm understanding where he's coming from or trying to. And I'm accepting that, you know, things are going to happen with the characters that I might not like. But in the end, I'm going to love them no matter what. Because they are my characters. This is my show. I love it. So that's all I wanted to say. I'm sorry if it was just rambly, but Archie Andrews, man. Gotta love him. And then, you know, KJ. Who doesn't love KJ? Which, oh my god. First off, let me, since this is on the top.